Officials from the United States Army's Program Executive Office Missiles and Space, PEO MS, and Army Contracting Command, ACC, Redstone Arsenal, executed an undefinitized contract award for Guided Multiple Launch Rocket System, or GMLRS, rocket production. The contract awarded to Lockheed Martin Missiles and Fire Control is worth $4.1 billion and will procure GMLRS, Extended Range or ER-GMLRS missiles, and associated hardware. The interesting bit is the mention of ER-GMLRS. It's evident that the ER variant is now getting into serious serial production. The systems are expected to be produced at the company's Precision Fires Center of Excellence in Camden, Arkansas. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how new ER-GMLRS would elevate the lethality of HIMARS and M270 MLRS. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. If someone had not been living under a rock, the person would have heard about HIMARS. HIMARS has undeniably been one of the most crucial weapons the U.S. has provided to Ukraine. The platform has been used to blow up Russian ammunition depots, command and control centers, bridges, and even air defenses. The M142 High Mobility Artillery Rocket System, or HIMARS, is a light multiple rocket launcher mounted on a standard Army M1140 truck frame. HIMARS can fire a wide range of rockets and missiles, which includes standard unguided rockets, GMLRS or guided MLRS, and MGM-140 Army Tactical Missile System or Army TACMS. GMLRS has been a key weapon that can also be fired from M270 MLRS. Lockheed Martin announced its next generation extended range GMLRS sometime back, and several tests have been carried out. The standard GMLRS is part of Lockheed Martin's MLRS family of munitions, MFOM, a series of precision strike rockets and missiles designed to be low cost and low risk. As Lockheed Martin explains, the rockets reduce collateral damage and provide tremendous capability and flexibility in addressing today's threats. GMLRS is a precision-guided rocket that can deliver a high explosive payload to targets with high accuracy. It uses GPS and has a range of 46 miles or 75 kilometers. GMLRS integrates a 90-kilogram or 200-pound unitary warhead, and these have a reliability rating exceeding 98%. The ER-GMLRS variant has enhanced capabilities compared to the standard GMLRS. The last known test was carried out in March this year at White Sands Missile Range, New Mexico. Viewers may note that White Sands Missile Range in New Mexico is a 3,200 square mile or 8,288 square kilometer facility where the world's first atomic bomb detonation took place. In that exercise, two rockets were fired from the U.S. Army's High Mobility Artillery Rocket System, HIMARS, launcher against targets. That test follows a successful trial of ER-GMLRS system at the same range in September 2023, during which the missile achieved a range of approximately 93 miles, or 150 kilometers, nearly double that of the current GMLRS. As per Lockheed Martin, the rockets successfully targeted and engaged a set of targets that met the required criteria for missile performance. Jay Price, Vice President of Precision Fires at Lockheed Martin Missiles and Fire Control, had said, "This test demonstrates nearly double the range while maintaining the precision GMLRS is known for." He had added, "Lockheed Martin is committed to advancing this critical capability on a rapid timeline for our Army customers, and this test moves ER-GMLRS one step closer to fielding." It was disclosed in June that Lockheed was awarded a $200 million fiscal 2024 contract modification to build as many as 240 extended-range GMLRS. The ER-GMLRS includes a larger motor and has enhanced maneuverability due to its tail-driven control systems. Apart from extending the range, improved precision ER-GMLRS provides mission-customizable payloads. Possible warhead loadouts include unitary, high-explosive, anti-armor, and others tailored for specific target types or tactical objectives. Similar to legacy GMLRS, the extended range variant can be fired from both HIMARS and M270 MLRS. Lockheed Martin has produced more than 60,000 GMLRS rounds and is under annual contract to continue production of GMLRS unitary and alternative warhead rockets, including integrated logistics support for the U.S. Army, U.S. Marine Corps, and international customers. Douglas Bush, the U.S. Army's Assistant Secretary for Acquisition, Logistics, and Technology, said the award is intended to be definitized as part of a three-year, multi-year contract demonstrating the Army's commitment to accelerating and stabilizing production capability for this critical weapon system, which continues to support the U.S. Army and Joint Force, along with Ukraine and other allies around the world. Major General Frank Lozano, Program Executive Officer, Missiles and Space, said, "Multi-year contracts are mutually beneficial to the United States government and our industry partners." He added, "They strive to lower procurement costs by allowing bulk purchasing and reducing administrative strain and costs associated with annual contract renewals, while also providing our suppliers with a stable demand forecast, encouraging investment in production capacity and capability improvements." Despite appearing primitive, artillery remains vital on the battlefield, serving both defensive and offensive purposes. An artillery barrage effectively suppresses enemy activity and can even have a psychological effect, demoralizing opponents. Moreover, it offers an economical and expedient alternative to air support. GMLRS's greater strike envelope and precision compared to traditional artillery makes it so effective. ER-GMLRS builds on this even further. The fact that Ukraine was mentioned is bad news for Russia, since it's likely that ER-GMLRS could soon end up in Ukrainian hands.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.